And no, I did not forget the 4 in my username. That's a story for another day. I clicked on the forgot your password thing. Let it write. Parents, emails. But I was a responsible child. And guess what it said? Invalid liquid name or email address. But this is just new pets all over again. So I'm just gonna go ahead and create a new account. Oh, well, come on, Club Penguin. You trying to expose me and get my new Club Penguin account hacked already? Oh, no. Parents, email. Oh, pickle pizza. What captures the heart of children? I don't blame you. Here we go. So how did I get into it? Well, one evening when I was about 7 or 8 years old, I was at my cousin's house and she showed me a game she was playing on the computer. It looked like a lot of fun, so I asked what it was and she said, Club Penguin. Then I said, you mean Penguin Club? And then she said, no, it's called Club Penguin. And then I said, no, the adjective has to come before the noun. Trust me, I'm a year older than you. It's definitely Penguin Club. And then she said, but it's called Club Penguin. I said, you stupid. Anyway, I opened up Club Penguin on the laptop, made it on the ground, and let it be the end of my life. One of the first things that I mentioned about Club Penguin was throwing snowballs. I don't know why, but it was an oddly satisfying. Someone out and throw snowballs at them. They started throwing snowballs back, but it wouldn't stop there. Nah, I'd keep throwing snowballs at them. Then people got bored and went somewhere else. Then I'd find a new place they're in and throw snowballs at them until they left the map and went to their igloo. Then I'd go to their igloo and throw more snowballs at them until they left the server and joined another one. Then I'd find the new server they're in and throw even more snowballs at them until they logged off the game. Then I Google Maps their home address. Club Penguin also had a lot of great places to explore. There was the lighthouse, the coffee maker, the pizza bar. But my favorite place was definitely the coffee bar, because that's where the library was. They used to have this book series called Play My Letter. And I know what you're thinking. You logged on to an online game to read. The answer is yes. Club Penguin managed to keep up with the years of 2007 and 2011. Play My Letters wasn't just about reading books. It was a mini game where you would type the letters on the screen to reveal the rest of the story. And depending on what you type, you can even change small details of the story, such as whether the player wants to make it to me, or this makes it safe. You can see it's a bit of a guess it was a way to get kids to improve their typing skills, and it definitely worked in my case because my typing speed is now at an astounding 79 words per minute. I mean, I'm no Izzy typing at 216 words per minute, but anyways, let's face it, nobody joins Club Penguin to read books. It's all about the games, and you can tell the people over at Club Penguin worked very hard to make sure that they came up with as many Penguin-themed games as possible. I can almost imagine the board meetings that they came up with these ideas. They had penguin surfing, penguin fishing,
penguin wakeboarding, penguin toboggan, and then one person was just like, hey, how about penguin jetpack? After each game, you would be rewarded with a certain amount of coins depending on how well you did. Some